Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Basement Electronics. A few episodes ago, when I was setting up the Raspberry Pi 3, I mentioned that it did have built-in Bluetooth on it, but I didn't want to cover it in that video, and then I said I'd make another video. So here we are. So anyone who has set up Bluetooth in the past knows that it can be really fussy. And especially, at least in my experience, Bluetooth in Linux can be hit or miss. And with it seems the Raspberry, it seems the Bluetooth on the Raspberry Pi is certainly no different. When I was going through forums to figure out how to do this, there's been quite a few comments that some people say, works great, everything works exactly as expected. Some people have said that, it starts to work fine and then the device disconnects. And then there's other people who say it doesn't work at all completely. But we're going to give it a solid try. But at the same time, I can't really make any promises because this is Bluetooth in Linux. But then again, anyone who's followed my videos in the past knows that that I can be hit and miss sometimes. So let's get this started. So you can see I've already have an SSH connection open to the Raspberry Pi. Since we are going to be working in the console, we really don't need a graphical interface, so the SSH will work just as fine. So first thing we're gonna do is become root. And then whenever you do something like this, it's always recommended to make sure that all your packages are up to date. So since this is a Debian-based distribution, first of all, we update our repositories. And so I'm just gonna clip this through so you don't have to sit and watch it. Right, so now that that's done, we're actually going to We're actually going to upgrade the distribution. Now, this shouldn't be too bad. Yeah, there's only a few packages that need to be updated. But yeah, this is going to take a few minutes, so I'm just going to come back. There. So we now have a an up-to-date Raspberry Pi. Now we're just going to reboot it. Oh, I know a lot of people use the actual reboot command to like for the Raspberry Pi. I like using init 6 because there are all sorts of stances on how to reboot your computer. I know that init 6 will at least change the initialization level of your Linux computer, and it will properly run the shutdown scripts for the various services running. Likewise, it'll properly sync your disks before it reboots it. My understanding is that the shutdown command and the reboot command may not necessarily do that. So this is just me being safe. Let's see. I might type, I don't know. There. So here we are. Nice fresh up-to-date Raspberry Pi 3 running Raspbian Linux. will become root again. Now, the packagers of Raspbian were really nice, and they created a package called Pi Bluetooth. And so this package itself is, you knew about that. Interesting. So Pi Bluetooth is a it's basically an empty package with dependency of the Blues and Blues firmware packages. So that's just oh, it is installed. Okay, so I guess that's already been taken care of for us. So the first thing we're going to do with the Blues package comes a command called Bluetooth CTL, and it opens up a new shell, like a Bluetooth shell. So if we type help, here are the commands that are available for us. So list, there's our controller, which is, so this is our onboard Bluetooth controller. So now if we do a list of devices, okay, so it of course comes up empty because we don't have anything attached to it yet. But if we go show, here's all the information about the actual Bluetooth controller. So we are going to pair these. They're just simple pair of Bluetooth headphones. You may have seen me wear them from time to time because they also have like a standard jack on the bottom for, so I can hook them directly up to the audio out. But yeah, I use these for all my audio work for my videos. So I'm just going, so first of all, I'm going to just put these in discover mode. These here. So now power on, turn on, and scan on. Huh. Interesting. Now the one problem is I am going to have to assume this is the headphones, because this is just a little dongle I have in my keychain so I can find them with my phone. So how do we do that? Ah, yes. Connect. Attempting to connect. Success! Multimedia player. What did I just connect? Connected. No. Yes. Alright. So it's connected. I'm just going to cheat here for a second. That's not going to tell me anything. Wow. That's interesting. Found my computer. All right, so that's how you connect. In theory, unfortunately, I don't know. I can't remember for sure. I will. I'm highly confident that this is my headset, but because it's not giving a name, like it's doing for the computer and for my my little keychain dongle. Can't be absolutely sure. So, instead, we're going to install the GUI for this, and we're going to see what this looks like for the X Windows. So I'll be back in just a minute. So here we have our familiar Raspberry Pi desktop. First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to open a terminal. Become root. And I'm going to install an application called Blue Man. Blue Man is an X Windows. Oh, okay, that has a few dependencies. Okay, so Blue Man is it's an X Windows widget for managing your Bluetooth devices, and it'll show up in the top taskbar using the traditional Bluetooth logo. So we're gonna let this go because this is gonna take a few minutes, and I'll be back once this is done, and we can start up Blue Man. Done. So now this is done. Let's see what we have. There we go. Bluetooth Manager. You can see the arrow spinning away. Oh, there we go. I'm going to try this again. Well, you know what? I don't think I actually had this in Discover mode before. There we go. Search. Do it again. Let's try this.
What I almost think I need to do is turn the Bluetooth off on my main computer because I think it might be interfering. Okay. All right, so whatever that device is, could be my headset, could be a lot of different things. So my Raspberry Pi now thinks that it's connected and it's set up. It would have been nice if it had some sort of database for the IDs, like for these. Because it would have been nice to know what exactly that is. Or even identify whether, because my understanding is most of these, try marking as trusted. Most of these devices will actually broad, well, like, you know, some will, broadcast their name. Some will, No, some will actually identify whether they're an audio or media device. Let's try one thing. CL. Show. Oh, interesting. So you notice in the Bluetooth shell, it actually showed the TKR device going away. Same time disappeared from the list, so it. No. So it kind of shows you, the two are talking with each other. Oh, that's not a controller. Okay. Oops. What if we did this? There we go. All right, so it says it's a multimedia player. All right. So I'm going to leave this video here because this is it. No, this is how you get your Bluetooth working. I'm going to play with it for a bit outside the videos. Make sure it is, and if it isn't working or if there's anything else that that still needs to be done, I'll post it in a blog. I'll put a blog together with updates. But thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you found it interesting. If not, informative. So we'll see you next time. Bye.